solving rational equations involves getting rid of these fractions. The nice thing with the equations is you eliminate stuff. That's always how I look at it. Eliminate. Our whole goal is to get that m equal to something. So the first thing we do is we take every single denominator and factor them, just like this. And I'll put that one in a parenthesis. And then we write the LCD, which is 9, m plus 2. Because 3 and 9 is 9, and then we have an m plus 2. The next thing we have to do is put a restriction. So since these are denominators, we go back to our undefined value. Remember with this, denominators can never equal 0. So like here, x cannot equal negative 2, x cannot equal 2 or negative 1, and then 2 or 3. So we have that same situation here. If you get an answer, it has to work with the equation. So when we have our LCD, you take every single factor from the LCD, you set them not equal to 0, and solve. Which means we have a restriction that m cannot equal negative 2. And if you check it by plugging it in, negative 2 plus 2 is 0. 4 divided by 0, that's undefined. So as long as we don't get a negative 2 for an answer, we're good. All right, so now that we've factored the denominators, we found the LCD, now we use the LCD. And what we're going to do is multiply both sides of the equation by the LCD. And as we multiply it, what it's going to do is be distributed. So we're going to put a 9 m plus 2 here, a 9 m plus 2 here, and then a 9 m plus 2 on the other side of the equation as well. And now that we've done that, this should remove all of our fractions. And there we go. No more fractions. So we end up with is a 9 times 4 minus an 11 and m plus 2 and equals 3. And I really recommend writing all of these out first. Don't just try to do it quickly. So we have 9 and 4, m plus 2 and 11, and then a 3. We don't want to miss anything. So now we can simplify. There we go. So that's our equation. And the last thing is just to solve that equation. You notice this is nice and clean. So 36 minus 22, that's 14. I forgot the m. Minus 14, minus 14, that's negative 11. That's negative 11m. Divide by negative 11. And we get 1. That's it. How do you know it's correct? You go back and check it. So if we plug it into the original equation, should be true. That's 4/3. Move that over a little bit. 4/3 minus 11/9, common denominator. That's 12 minus 11 is 1/9. And then on the other side, we get 1/9. Checks out. So we know we're 100% correct. All right, let's do another one just to go through it twice. So we need to factor our denominators. So the first one is 3, and then k plus 2, minus 2, and then k plus 2, k minus 2, and then 1 over k minus 2. So our LCD would be we have a k plus 2 and a k minus 2. And then now we need to find out what k cannot equal. So if we take each of those factors, set them not equal to 0, it tells us that k cannot equal negative 2 or 2. So as long as we don't get a negative 2 or a 2, we're good. All right. So now the next thing. So now we're going to multiply everything. So we're going to rewrite the problem and leave some spaces. And now we'll multiply by that common denominator to each one. me double check our problem, make sure we're good. K plus 2, minus is there. Okay, we're good. All right, so now we can just cancel. K plus 2 with K plus 2, so we have a 3 and a K minus 2. They all cancel, which leaves us with a minus 2. And then over here, the K minus 2, so now we have a K plus 2. And there's our equation we get to solve. So by distributing, we can solve it. I'm going to solve it twice. Add both sides twice. So we get 10 equals 2k divided by 2. And there's our answer. And we go back and check our restrictions. Does not hit any of our restrictions. So if we go back and plug it back in, it should be correct. So 3 over 5 plus 2 minus 2 over, I'm going to square it, so 25 minus 4. And that should equal 1 over 5 minus 2. So that's 3 sevenths minus 2 over 21. Common denominator is 3. So 9 minus 2 would be 7 over 21. Reduced, which gives us 1/3. And there it is, 1 divided by 5 is 1/3. Checks. I know this is a horrible looking way to check here, but I ran out of space. So we're good. And that's solving equations. So again, the steps are factor the denominators, and we do this so that we can find an LCD, and then we use our LCD to write our restrictions. And then we multiply both sides of the equation, every single group that we have, by that LCD, and it remove every single fraction, which leaves us a nice equation that we can solve. Check our restriction, and then check the answer. And that's everything.